For those who don't know me, my name is Sarah. I'm the community project coordinator here at CCRM. The cooking nutrition program, we have, right now we're doing about 2 workshops a month, and we really like to highlight just local wisdom. We have such a diverse community in Chautauqua County. I was especially excited to have a Korean intern this summer and this semester, Minju. Those of you who've been here before probably recognize her. She's been volunteering at some of the workshops. Dunkirk is very diverse, but we don't have a lot of Asian diversity here. So it's nice that the college happens to have kind of a larger Korean population. So we have 3 excellent Korean students. If you have any questions, they're all very happy to answer your questions about Korean food and just Korean culture in general. If you haven't been here before, we have some surveys on the back table. Fill those out and just let us know what you thought of the class. It helps us improve the program. Also on the back table, Minju prepared the packet of information. It has all the recipes we're going to eat today, and also just a little bit of a description of each dish. And the last thing I was going to say, I told Minju, you know, share whatever you want about Korean food and Korean culture. But really the best part of these classes is hearing your own questions and just comments and input. So at any point, feel free to raise your hand and throw out questions for her. She's excited to answer your questions. So I'll go relieve her from frying tofu, and she'll be right up. And this is Minju Kim.
Hi.
I go to SUNY Fredonia right now. I'm studying there, studying journalism. And today I cooked some of the popular Korean dish that we have in our country. And there are 3. One is gimbap, and another is tofu, but it's fried tofu. And the other is kimchi. Kimchi is fermented vegetable that we eat like almost every day with every dish, mostly with rice. And I wanted to introduce you some of our common foods in Korea because they're very healthy and very delicious. So if you have any questions about Korean food, or it could be just anything about Korea, feel free to ask any kind of questions. I will start with how to make kimbap. Kimbap is kind of roll, like California roll, sushi roll. So we, for the ingredients, we have all of these. These are cucumber, carrots, pickled radish, spinach, ham, and eggs, and fish cake. But for kimbap, you can put basically any kind of ingredients you want to put. Now in Korea, we sometimes put tuna in it. Tuna, or we put cheese. We put also cheese in it. It's really good. And so we have this dried seaweed. This is called kim. So kimbap means seaweed rice. So we just like roll. And we have sticky rice. So I'm going to show you how to make this. It's really simple and easy to make. And this special equipment is called pal. This is for rolling the sushi. And you can get this from maybe Asian market in Buffalo. But still, my mom didn't use this when she used to make kimbap for me when I had to go to field trip. But if you have bar, it's easy to make. So what you do is put the bar on the desk, and then seaweed, dried seaweed, and the rice. This is steamed rice. Basically, spread the sticky rice on the seaweed, maybe a half or like 2/3 of the surface of the seaweed. And then you put any kind of ingredient you want. I'll just put the basic ingredients that we have in Korea. Fish cake, cucumber, egg,
spinach. Do you use a lot of meat or mostly seafood type?
We use only ham for the gimbap or eggs, but mostly it's vegetables. Then after you put all the ingredients on it, all you have to do is just roll it using the pot. Can you guys see this? Not really. And this is, it's like this. I'll put all the ingredients on it right now. So I just rolled it with the pot like this. Then go press for once or twice. So with all the ingredients are like packed inside. Then you keep rolling till the end of maybe like 1 centimeter. Then because this is dry seaweed, it might like fall out like this. So you want to put some a little bit of the sticky rice to use it as a glue, kind of glue. Then you roll it. And then this is the shape of the gimbap. And you cut it like this, and then do you have any questions so far?
You chill that after you roll it?
Huh?
You chill it. Refrigerate it.
No, you don't have to refrigerate it. No. You can just eat it right on hand. But for kimbap, because of the rice and all the ingredients in it, it might go bad quickly. So if you make kimbap, it's good to eat it like in 24 hours.
Yeah, too. The cube looked like it was real stiff, but yet you could roll it.
Yeah.
So how does that work if it's real stiff?
It's like, it's specially made for kimbap. Yeah,
oh, okay.
It's very flexible.
And the other question, you called that Kim, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, so many people in Korea have the name Kim. Does it mean that?
No, not really.
What
but
is it?
It sounds exactly the same, but it's totally different. My name is Minju Kim. But this is not the Kim.
Oh.
I think this Kim is like pure Korean. They don't have Chinese character. But for like last name, Kim, as last name, it's like it has Chinese character.
Oh, okay.
And the request from the outer talking or something.
Okay, I'm sorry.
You're okay.
Any other questions? And I'll start explaining the next food, tofu. Today I'm going to serve pan-fried tofu. Tofu is a good source for protein, it's vegetable protein. And a lot of Asian countries like Korea, China, Japan, we all eat tofu. And there are different kinds of tofu. Today I use the firm tofu, not the silky smooth one. Because for the silky and smooth one, you use it when you make soup or stew with it. And for firm tofu, you can fry it, or you can just eat it as a raw with kimchi. And for the tofu, I have the sauce. This is basically soy sauce with green onions and a little bit of red pepper powder in it. You can eat this with tofu. There will be